This is Chris Whalen, CPA, and welcome to the Street Level Business Podcast. First, if you already have a question for me, please pause the podcast and call me on 732-673-0510. My CPA firm specializes in business and income tax matters for businesses and families and offers the full array of services you would expect from a full-service CPA firm. As the name implies, this podcast offers advice for those of us working and living at the street level. If you look at your screen, you will see my website and phone number, both great ways to reach me. This podcast starts a new series that I am calling News Analysis for Business Owners. I get many questions how international and national events will impact businesses and families. In this series, I will be discussing only those events that I feel will have a direct impact on those of us working and living at the street level. The other headlines I will ignore. So, here are some headlines that I skipped because they really don't have an impact on our daily lives yet. Cryptocurrencies. A lot of news about these, but as they're really not being used easily and openly in commerce, we can skip this. Jeffrey Epstein is dead. When he was alive, he had no impact on our daily lives, so his death makes no difference. The Hong Kong protests, not much impact. The housing market slowdown, not much impact either. North Korea, no real impact on us on a daily basis, so I passed on that too. Okay, now on to the headlines that are impacting us. The China trade wars. The tariffs on Chinese goods have definitely had a negative impact on my clients getting product and supplies from China. This simply increases the cost, which is going to destroy your profit margins if you do not increase your prices. Of course, increasing your prices makes you less competitive. But on the flip side, this is giving my CPA firm more business as we are assisting more and more clients to find suppliers outside of China for the goods or supplies that they require. So although there is some financial pain with the Chinese tariffs, overall it is expanding my clients' reach and will eventually lead to higher profits as these Chinese tariffs are now making it more competitive around the world to supply what China used to be able to supply so cheaply. The next topic is crop losses. We've heard a lot of this in the news that the corn and wheat crops are being devastated due to storms, and that's the truth, but corn and wheat are some of the least nutritious foods that we have and are the main causes of the obesity epidemic in the country. So corn and wheat being more expensive now and limited is a great thing for the health of the country. We need to increase the cost of unhealthy food so people eat them less. So this is a natural disaster that will cause that to happen. Corn and corn products have almost no dietary benefits to humans. We didn't evolve to eat them. So the business impact is going to be higher prices for the products that contain these crops that have been lost. Corn and wheat-based products will be increasing in price due to scarcity. The next topic is the student loan debt crisis. Those of you that subscribe to my blog have heard me talk about this a lot, so let's get into it. The big thing we've heard from so many sectors is bailout, bailout. That is the wrong path to take. This is a very important point coming up. If someone earns a four-year degree and they are unable to support themselves, of course they have been defrauded and they deserve a full refund from the college. This is regardless if the so-called education was financed with student loans. This is just like lemon laws for cars. If I bought a car and it didn't work, I get my money back. Shouldn't a college education be held to at least the consumer protection standards for cars? Of course it should. To draw another analogy, during the run-up to the mortgage crisis, banks were giving mortgages to people that should not have been approved. Similarly, colleges were taking money financed by student loans and giving out degrees that were worthless or subprime. So that is why we have a very similar bubble in student loan debt. We have bad student loans, again, subprime student loans, where the underlying financial basis did not justify the making of those loans. Student loans, just like mortgages, need much stricter underwriting guidelines. The student loan debacle is the largest consumer fraud I have seen in my lifetime, and it has drained trillions of dollars from the middle class that will never be seen again. If you have a four-year degree and a student loan you cannot pay, then sue your college or university for fraud. Ask anyone this question and they will answer, of course. Should a four-year degree provide you with a life-supporting job upon graduation? I can hear all of you saying, of course. So let's reframe this conversation about student loan debt from taxpayer bailouts to placing blame and shame where it belongs on the institutions that stole your money. Your neighbors should not be forced to pay for the money your college stole from you to give you a worthless degree. The next topic is the G7 Summit. Anyone who deals with international markets, this means if you're selling overseas from the United States or if you have vendors supplying you from overseas, then the trade deals that may come out of this summit are things you really need to keep on your radar. Trump had a lot of good conversations with the leaders of all the major countries, and you need to see if the countries in question are in your supply chain or you have clients there. The next topic is the Ruth Bader Ginsburg cancer scare. If Trump gets to appoint another Supreme Court justice, this is fantastic for those of us working and living at the street level. We want justices that are friendly to business and that will be less imposing with their decisions when it comes to regulations and taxes. So we want Ruth Bader Ginsburg to retire as soon as possible, hopefully voluntarily, and not due to divine intervention. Next topic, San Francisco and other California towns becoming third world countries. More and more of my business clients are choosing to leave California, especially the major cities, or have already left California. Probably only 20% of my clients who were in California 10 years ago are still there. Major cities being overrun with homelessness and the streets and storefronts being used as toilets, of course, make it impossible to run a safe and clean and sanitary business. What's my advice here? Avoid all major California cities for any physical location for your business. There are zero benefits left. The homeless and illegal aliens have more rights than American citizens there. The next topic is border wall construction. Every person I know who is against the border wall would never be personally impacted in a negative way from illegal immigration. It's that simple and they are that transparent. Having open borders destroys the lives of lower-income Americans because their jobs can be easily taken and the wages undercut by illegal alien workers. Ask anyone that you know who believes that the border is immoral this question. Let's say an illegal immigrant comes over the border today, and tomorrow you see that illegal immigrant at your desk and you have been fired because that illegal immigrant will work for half of your salary. In that case, would you go back in time and have the border wall built so your job and family are secure? Of course you would. This is why all of the open border supporters are disingenuous and they're out of touch with the true American citizen impact of having open borders. Once I pose this question, everyone says of course they would want to have the border wall to protect their family and protect their interests. So we have to protect the Americans who can't help themselves and who are at risk for losing their jobs and their entire lives when illegals take their jobs. Small business owners, please only hire workers verified as legal to work here. Especially those in the lower income and lower wage groups need our support more than ever. This is never broadcast on television as it would contradict the narrative of how open borders are the best thing for us and the moral thing to do. This brings us to the end of this edition of the Street Level Business Podcast. Questions? Concerns? Call me on 732-673-0510. Thanks for listening. I hope you found this podcast informative. If you want to become a subscriber to my business and tax memos, please send an email to chriswhalencpa@gmail.com and I will add you. Remember, the moment that you have a business or tax question is the moment you should be calling me. Have a great day.